use the Laplace transform to solve the initial value problem. So for this one, you have the derivative in the delta involved. So I'm gonna work step by step from the left to right, from left to right. So on the left side, I'm going to apply the derivative theorem. So I have s y times capital Y of s minus s y of 0 minus y prime of 0 plus this one, 2s capital Y of s minus 2y of 0 equals. So for this one, this is called the direct delta function. And if you don't remember, the Laplace transform of direct delta function is equal to e to the negative s t naught. So whatever t naught here is, you just plug it into here. So in this case, I have e to the negative f, right? Because the t naught is just 1. Now plug in the conditions, y of 0 equals 0. So this becomes 0. This becomes 0. And y prime of 0 equals 1. So just leave it like there. Take a look at the capital Y of s is, factor out capital Y of s, and left with s square plus 2s equals e to the negative s. So y prime of 0 equals 1. Plug in 1 here, negative 1, move to the other side, positive 1. Okay. Now divide both sides by s square plus 2s. So at the same time, I'm going to factor it out. Okay, so divide both sides by s square plus 2s, so this is when you multiply them out, you're going to have s square plus 2s. So to save time, I just do two steps in once. Okay, now, for this one, you may think of using partial fraction decomposition method, but I don't want to do that because I see the easier way of doing that. So you could use that method, but it's gonna be lengthy and it just wastes time. So what I'm gonna do is to use a shortcut. So we are going to, so this can be obtained from something over s plus something over s plus 2. I'm gonna do it for this one first, and this one you just bring it over because they look exactly the same. There's no difference between them, okay? Alright, so in order to use a shortcut, you need to have the s and s to the first power, right? So this one is s plus 0 times s plus 2. So they are off by 2, right? So I'm going to have 1/2 on top. And by the way, if you haven't had a chance to watch the video that I made about finding partial fraction decomposition in less than 30 seconds, I'll put the link in the upper right corner here so you can go there to watch that video. It's very helpful and saves your time a lot. And okay, now we have the numerator and denominator. The next step is to determine which one has the negative sign. As I experienced, the bigger one will carry the negative sign, so this one will carry the negative sign. And double check, negative 1/2 times s plus 1/2 times s 0, 1/2 times 2, which is 1, right? Okay, we good. And for this one, you just bring this over, right? Very fast, because I do it and explain it at the same time, so you may, it may take longer than it should be, but if I just did it along, it would take me like about 5 seconds or less. Right, now apply the error inverse on both sides. So on the left side I have y of t, on the right side I'm going to have, let's do this first. Okay, that gives you u of t minus 1, right? Now for this one, you are going to have 1/2, right? L of this is 1/2 minus 1/2. L of this is e to the negative 2t, right? That's because you have the unit step function, so the t has to match up. That means that you actually need to have t minus 1 instead of just t, okay? That's it for this one. Now for this one, same thing except for this one. So you have 1/2 minus 1/2 e to the negative 2t. Okay? So because there are no unit step function here, so this is what you need to have. And for this one, you have a unit step function, so whenever you see t, it has to be t minus 1. Okay? That's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos.
Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.